Welcome back, and if it's your first time to the channel, welcome. Well, on today's video, we're taking a look at a portable display with a hidden feature, I guess. Well, it's not really hidden, it's marketed pretty well. However, at the moment, I use a ultra-wide screen for my productivity and photo video editing, just because it gives you so much more real estate to do stuff. However, this portable display will give me something that ultra-wide does not. It's supposed to give me touch control on my Mac. Now, I'm already fully aware that if it works pretty well with Windows, just because Windows is already quite optimized for touch input because of the surface lineup. But how it works with Mac, that's what I'm interested in, and that's what we're going to find out today. Comes with different, well, it doesn't come with, you buy these accessories separately. So you've got the Espresso Mount, and then we've got the Espresso Pen, which you can buy separately. We'll talk about prices later on, but let's have a look how this works. Let's unpackage it and see what comes in the box, etc. So stay tuned while we unbox it. So I'll put the pen and the stand to the side, and let's see, it's wrapped up. There we go. There we go, we've got that ripped. This section is a lot easier to take apart because, as you can see, it's got an easy peel section there, which is much appreciated, to be honest. Which is supposed to work a little bit better than that, but hey, what can you do? See if we can peel it. There you go, that'll do. Okay, so it opens up top and bottom, and then it says More Anywhere, World's Thinnest Portable Display. So actually, before I open it, one thing I want to show you is some specifications on the back. So it's a 15.6 inch LCD display, 1080p panel, 300 nits brightness. It's got 60 hertz refresh rate. It is a premium aluminium and glass body. It does offer features like auto rotate, so you can rotate it vertically, horizontally, and then it will auto rotate the picture. It's 5.3 millimeters thin, which is super, super thin. And then you've got palm rejection for the live draw stuff. But like I said, we'll see how that works on Mac because that's what I'm interested in. And then we've got a list of accessories that are sold separately that we'll discuss later when I introduce them. So let's go back to opening the box. Open these two, open these flaps. And I've got to say, it looks very nice. And it feels straight away when I take it out of the box. You know that feeling you get when you hold a Mac and you get that cold feeling for the aluminium on the back? That's what you get here. Such a nice feeling. Feels like premium item should feel. Got a bit of Espresso branding down there, and then a logo in the middle, and then logo in the middle there as well. So we've got that. What else does it come with? Got the USB-C to USB-C cable, because that is actually all we need to connect it to the Mac. We've got a cleaning cloth and just a card. Now, one thing I do like about what Espresso do is they don't include a bunch of pointless manuals in, like, waste of paper that other companies do. They've got this QR code in there for user guides, and I believe that's the same for the pen, where if you do want to read the actual manual user guide, just scan the QR code, it takes you to the site and you can read the manual. And if you don't, you don't have to throw away more paper and waste it. So it's all good stuff so far. I think that's the box done. So let's put cleaning cloth down there, take that cable, and let's pop this back and this on back. It's a bit fidgety. There we go. And we'll leave the display down there. I do like the fact that you only need one USB-C cable to actually power and power and use the display. Before I plug it in though, I want to put it on the mount. So this is the Espresso mount. Super cool because all it essentially is a, it's quite heavy mount that folds out, and it's got magnets on the back which attaches to the magnets on the back of the display. So it looks like that, and then folds out. Got a bit of silicone at the bottom to grip onto surfaces so it doesn't slide around everywhere, and it will be like that, and then the display will go on top of that and magnetize to this section right here. So let's magnetize that on. There we go. Very strong connection, I gotta say. I thought that was gonna. And then on the side here, we've got two USB-C ports. I think one's just for charging, and then one's for charging and display connection. So let's connect it to. I'm gonna have to disconnect the ultra wide and plug in the Espresso display. There we go. So you can see that the touch does work, the cursor's moving around, and the selection does work. One thing I want to test is the pen. So pen comes in this box, slide it out, take the pen out, and then like I said, very minimal, scan the QR code to get the user guide. And then in the box we get a spare cable to charge the pen and a spare tip for the pen, because they can wear out, just like the Apple Pencil. Let's see the pen. The pen does remind me a little bit of the Apple Pencil, second gen one. So the top and bottom sections of the pen are, see if I can, are a little bit flatter, just for optimal writing, I guess, and drawing. Got USB-C on the side to charge it, Espresso branding, and then we've got a button there to, I guess it will be used with, depending on which app you use. So one thing I did want to test is, if I go into Affinity Photo, I made kind of a test to see if it's any accurate, me using the pen versus just using the mouse. So I've made a little test here. You can see there's a couple different shapes here, four different shapes. So circle, star, water drop, diamond. So on the right hand side, I'm going to try and draw this shape with the mouse. Left hand side, we're going to use the pen and try and draw it and see if there is any accuracy, better accuracy with the pen rather than using a mouse. So let's use the mouse first and do these shapes. So circle first, then star, water drop, and then diamond. Okay, pretty good. I'd say with the mouse, that's pretty good. Star's a bit funky, but let's try now with the pen. So let's do circle first and then star. Water drop and then more palm rejections. Not rejecting my palm, unfortunately. And let's do diamond. I'm going to do one more time just because it doesn't look that much different. So let's test it one more time just to see. Obviously, this is not the best test you can do, but for photo editing, it does give me a rough idea when it comes to drawing. The pen is, that's a bit funky again. The pen is a lot more comfortable to hold, obviously, than using a mouse. So let's see now. circle. So I think with a little bit of practice using the pen on the actual display, I could get quite a bit better at photo in, I wouldn't get better at photo editing, but it would be a lot faster to use the pen than using a mouse, especially if you've got the keyboard set up, which I've put away currently for the shortcuts. That would be quite interesting. So it's pretty good. Let's see. I've got a video here that I was editing, what I've already edited. And then select, and then you can move video files about. So you can actually video edit with the pen on this display with your Mac. Obviously you need to connect the cable, but I mean, it is a possibility. And obviously using the pen is a lot more, like I said, easier than using a mouse, more convenient. So that might actually be a bonus point to this display. This touch functionability has actually impressed me a lot, considering that Mac is not built for touch functionability. It doesn't have any products that are actually touch, unlike Windows, which has the Surface lineup and tablets that use Windows, so they're already integrated into it. This is not, but it's working very, very well. I think Espresso have had to do their own software manipulation type of to get this working, and it is working pretty good. Overall, the display looks very nice. It's enough brightness for inside, but 300 nits, you're going to be quite careful where you go when you're outside, because if you get direct sunlight on the screen, you might be quite limited to how much you can see. But indoors, yeah, no problems indoors. If you're using this as a secondary display to, like I said, do photo editing or video editing, or just use the pen to sign documents, etc., stuff like that, then that's great. Speaking of the pen and the stand, like I said, I was going to go through pricing. This 15.6 inch model display is actually £469. This is the version 2 model, which they've just released. The pen is an extra £79 if you want the pen. The stand is £69 if you want the stand. And then there is a case, which I'll show on screen, that you can actually get that attaches magnetically to the display, similar to how the new iPad ones attach to the iPad. Well, the case is actually £39. So if you was to get the whole bundle, it would come out to £656, which it's not cheap. I'm not going to lie, it's not cheap. But if this is something that you're looking for, this type of solution, this is, from what I've seen, one of the better implementations of the screen and the touch functionability of it. Obviously, like I said, links will be the below. If you do decide to get one, it makes no difference to me. The links will be below. I just wanted to showcase this display to you so you could see how it is before you actually make your decision. If you've got any questions about specifics of the display, leave them in the comments box below and I'll be sure to answer as many as I can. Okay, let's see now. So I'll put it about a third of the way. I don't know if you can hear that on your end, but
so when it's in, when you put the power bank inside the charging,
so that's at full volume,
the base, it will simultaneously charge the power bank and your phone once it's.
And I'm going to be honest, it's not that impressive. But then again, I wasn't expecting anything that impressive when coming from the speakers, because they're probably so tiny. But it's just an added extra for the display. Maybe the next one they make, they'll implement more stuff like better speakers and stuff like that. But considering this is the first one I've seen, touchscreen display that you can use with Mac, it's pretty cool. I'm going to play around a bit more the next couple of days, weeks, etc., with Photoshop and video editing and stuff like that. See if it changes anything in terms of how good things are. And like I said, if you have any questions regarding this display, leave a comment below and I'll answer any questions I can. Just because I can't think of everything when it comes to making the videos, so there is going to be things that I've forgotten. But I can be sure to answer the comment if you do leave it. If you want more videos like this, be sure to subscribe to the channel. It would be greatly appreciated. Like the video if you liked it, if you found it interesting, or if you just liked it in general. And hit the notification bell if you want to be notified of more future videos coming out. But yeah, that was the Espresso Display 15-inch version 2 and how to make your Mac touchscreen. And one thing to note is that was just Photoshop and video editing software. You can use the other software just as you would with a mouse, but it would, you can control it with your pen. So when it comes to stuff like control center and stuff like that, you can do all that with the pen. Cool stuff. Like I said, thank you for watching, and I'll catch you on the next one.